I greet you and welcome you to this video. In this video series, you will learn how to apply the rules of successful trading to improve your trading results over the next 12 months by applying the principles of successful trading. When I first started trading, one of the most difficult decisions I had to make was deciding how I wanted to structure my trading. What would be the most efficient way to make a profit? What criteria should I use to decide whether to buy or sell something? Starting with the age-old method of trial and error doesn't seem like a bad idea. Specifically, I found that prices seemed to know what I was doing and were moving in the opposite direction than I expected. So I started taking notes on what I was doing so I could see my mistakes after the fact. Even though I was convinced of this at the time, I now see that the corresponding entry signal is not able to accurately predict the future as I once believed. This is not the deciding factor in whether a trading approach is successful or not. Currently, all of my trading strategies are based on a few basic principles that have proven successful for me time and time again. I once heard a man named Earl Shove say that the basic rules of nature apply to everyone and that you will always be subject to the laws of gravity no matter what you do. Earl Shove was a mentor of Jim Rohn, and Tony Robbins was a student of Jim Rohn, and the two were friends. They passed their knowledge down from generation to generation. And gravity is as real today as it was 60 years ago, because it is a universal law. Although gravity is not a factor in trading, there are a few other guidelines you should follow in this situation. The law of large numbers is the first and most fundamental of all the principles. It is extremely important as it allows improving the probability of a system. The easiest way to describe it is with the help of a coin toss. When you flip a coin, you almost always get either heads or tails, at least most of the time. The chance that the coin will land on the border is quite small. If you don't catch it in time, it will most likely roll across the floor and under the cabinet. However, in the vast majority of cases, you will get either heads or tails, and that's all you can expect. If you flip a coin 5 times, you might get 3 heads and 2 tails, depending on how many times you flip it. This does not mean that one side of the coin is more effective than the other. If you base your trade on this result, you are committing what is called a base rate error, which is defined as follows. According to Investopedia, it is an error in which both the basis or starting point and the potential are undervalued. If you flip a coin 10,000 times, you can be sure that each side will be seen about 5,000 times. This is an example of the law of large numbers in action. When Thomas Edison was trying to develop the light bulb, he took advantage of this law. When asked about it, he explained that he was aware that at some point he would not be able to explain why a light bulb would not work. We are all familiar with the law of large numbers and apply it in a variety of situations, such as election predictions. It is possible to improve the quality of your observations by using a large base set that will help you improve your results and get probabilities that are above average. Imagine a roulette table where the house has the upper hand for the foreseeable future. In this video, we discussed how you can use the law of large numbers to get above average probabilities. In the next video, we'll talk about the black swan phenomenon, first described by Nassim Nicholas Taleb, who happens to be a trader.